गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 11th बायोलॉजी क्लास यूनिट 4th चैप्टर 13 और 18 ट्रांसपोर्ट इन प्लांट्स। टुडेज टॉपिक इज एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर बाय प्लांट्स। ऑल द लैंड प्लांट्स एब्जॉर्ब वाटर फ्रॉम सॉइल थ्रू देयर रूट सिस्टम्स। So there are some plants like grapes, solanum, beta, fasciolus, etc. Their water is partially absorbed through leaves. In the soil, water is present in between soil particles or space present in between the soil particles. Soil particles form the capillary like structures in which air and water is filled. This water is also known as soil water or capillary water. In particles of soils are intact, however, there is a space between the soil particles. These spaces are better known as pore space, which are filled up with gas and water. In fact, soil water is stored in these pore space. Total soil water is in technical term known as whole earth. Plants absorb water from soil, but the total soil water cannot be available for plants. Plant can absorb only a fraction of soil water. The amount of soil water that is available for plants is known as chesart. It constitutes about 75% of total water. Remaining 25% of water cannot be absorbed by plant. The portion of this soil water is known as echart. All type of waters are not available for the plants for the absorption purpose. There are water in soil, maybe in many forms. Or type of soil waters. Runaway water. After heavy rainfall, most of water run away and reaches to different water sources like rivers, lake, pond, ditches, and others. This is known as runaway waters, which is not available for absorption by plants. Gravitational water, this is also not available to the plants. This is the fraction of soil water that enter deep inside soil due to force of gravitation. It reaches to the water table in soil. Root of plants do not reach to the level of gravitational water, and therefore this is also not available to plants for absorption. Capillary water. This is the only water which is available to the plants. Some of the water. Some of soil water is held by soil particles and their pore and spaces. So the portion of capillary actions, therefore this is known as capillary water. This water is available to plants for absorption. Hygroscopic water. In soil, there are many type of materials which are hygroscopic in nature, means which absorb moisture from the soil or from atmosphere. Some amount of soil water is adhered around the molecule particles of such materials. This is known as hygroscopic water. Plants are unable to absorb this water also. Bound water are chemically bound water. Many compounds require some molecule of water for their molecular organizations. Example of these compounds are copper sulfate, CuSO4 plus 5, CuSO4, 5H2O. FeSO4, 7H2O, Na2SO4, H2O. This fraction of water in soil constitutes the bound water or chemically bound water. This cannot be available to the plants. And vaporized water. Or water vapors. A little amount of water remain in the form of vapor inside the air space of soil. This is known as vaporized water. Plants cannot absorb water vapor through their roots. In this way, we see that capillary water is the only soil water that is available to plants for absorption. This should always be remembered here that only tracheophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms, and angiosperms absorb water from soil through roots. Algae beings, aquatic, absorb water through whole of their body. Likewise, bryophytes absorb water from soil surface through their rhizoids. Soil in different regions of the world differ in their structural organization or texture. This is due to differences in the presence of minerals, organic material, soil organism, size of soil particles. The total amount of water retained in soil constitutes the field capacity of that soil. Sandy soil has least water holding capacity or least field capacity. It is about 45% when the amount of water soil is higher than its field capacity, the soil is said to be water lost. On the other hand, if the amount of water in soil is comparatively lower, plants show wilting with the decrease in the content of soil water. Ultimately, a situation develops when plants show permanent wilting and ultimately die. At this time, soil still has some amount of water. This amount of water is known as permanent wilting coefficients or simple wilting coefficients. So now it becomes clear that plants absorb water from soil through their root systems. Only capillary water is available to the plants for absorption through roots. Other type of waters are unavailable water to the plants. Water absorbing parts of a plant. In higher plants, water is absorbed through root hairs, which are in contact with soil water and form a root hair zone. There is present the root cap. Above it, there is cell division zone, cell elongation zones, and cell maturation zones. Have a numerous root hairs are present in permanent zones. This is called piliferous layers or root hair zones. The root hairs are tubular hair like prolongation of cells of epidermal layer of root. When epidermal layer bear root hairs, it is also known as piliferous layer. Balls of root hairs are permeable and consist of peptic substance. Root hair contain vacuole filled with cell shape. These peptic material and cellulose, after absorbing water by the process of imbibitions, get swelled up. Root hair zone is located to 10 cm behind the root tip. According to Karmar, maximum amount of water is absorbed through the zone of root hairs. Their xylem is not well developed and pericycle and endodermal cells are fully permeable. root hairs and their structures. Root hairs are protuberances of root epidermal cells. Is the outermost layer of root is called epidermis, which is made up of single layers, barrel shaped cells. From some epidermal cells are projected in the form of root hairs. These root hairs remain in contact with soil particles. Below the epidermis there is hypodermis or cortex, which may be divided into hypodermis, general cortex and endodermis. Root hairs are protuberances of root epidermal cells. These are found on peripheral wall of piliferous layers as tubular structures. These are the main organ of water absorption and are placed at the angle of 90 degree at the root surface. Length of root hairs varies from 1 to 10 millimeter and the diameter is about 10 millimicron. In herbaceous plants, number of root hairs in a root is higher in comparison to those of trees. The root hair zone is placed above the zone of elongation. The number and density of root hair varies from plant to plant. It is also affected by the age of root. Dittmer 1937 observed that there are about 14 billion root hairs in a 4 month old plant of rye. Total length of aggregate of root hairs may be up to 10,000 km with a surface area of about 400 square meters. The root hairs absorb the soil water present in capillaries of soil particles, or they absorb capillary water. The cell wall of root hairs is double layered. Outer wall is made up of pectin material while inner wall is made up of cellulose. In the middle of root hairs there is a large vacuole. In between the vacuoles and cell wall there is a thin layer of cytoplasm. Cell wall is permeable for both solute and solvent water and minerals. However, the cell membrane function as a differentially permeable membrane. Pathway of water through roots. Water enters the root mainly through the wall of root and epidermal cell of root tips. From the epidermal cells, water passes through the cells of cortex successively and then to the endodermis. Water enters the root mainly through the wall of the root and epidermal cells. Root hairs remain in direct contact with capillary water present between capillaries of soil particles. From the root hairs or from epidermal cells, water passes through the cells of cortex. From epidermis to the cells of cortex, from the cells of cortex to the endodermis, pericycles, and finally to the xylem basals. From the xylem of roots, the water is passes to the xylem of stems, branches, and finally to the xylem basals of leaves, and from xylem basals of leaves to the mesophyll tissues, epidermal tissues, and other tissues of the leaves. Apoplast and symplast concept of water absorption. The two terms apoplast and symplast were used by Munch to explain the flow of water. एंड मिनरल्स इन द प्लांट्स. एपोप्लास्टिक पैथवे, ही यूज द टर्म एपोप्लास्ट फॉर द नॉन लिविंग और डेड पोर्शन ऑफ द प्लांट्स लाइक इंटरकनेक्टिंग सेल वॉल, इंटरसेलुलर स्पेसेस, सेल वॉल ऑफ एंडोडर्मल सेल्स एक्सक्लूडिंग कैस्पेरियन स्ट्रिप्स, सेल वॉल ऑफ पेरिसाइकिल, जाइलम ट्रैकीज एंड बेसल्स. ऑल दीज नॉन लिविंग पोर्शन कॉन्स्टिट्यूट ए सिंगल सिस्टम कॉल्ड एपोप्लास्ट. इट फॉर्म्स एपोप्लास्टिक पैथवे विच हेल्प इन द ट्रांसलोकेशन ऑफ वाटर एंड आयन फ्रॉम सॉइल टू जाइलम ऑफ रूट्स. दिस सिस्टम इज कंटिन्यूअस थ्रू आउट द प्लांट एंड थ्रू दिस सिस्टम वाटर मूव चीफली ड्यू टू कैपिलरी एक्शन और फ्री डिफ्यूजन अलॉन्ग द डिफ्यूजन ग्रेडियंट. सिम्प्लास्टिक पैथवे, द टर्म सिम्प्लास्मा इज यूज बाई मंच फॉर द लिविंग पोर्शन ऑफ प्लांट लाइक साइटोप्लाज्मा. ऑल लिविंग सेल्स कनेक्टेड थ्रू प्लाज्मोडेस्माटा प्रेजेंट इन द सेल वॉल. सिंस ओनली द लिविंग सिस्टम इज इंक्लूडेड अंडर सिम्प्लास्ट, हियर द वाटर मूव चीफली ड्यू टू ऑस्मोसिस पास अवे फ्रॉम सिम्प्लास्ट इज कॉल्ड सिम्प्लास्टिक पाथवे ऑफ वाटर ट्रांसलोकेशन. मैकेनिज्म ऑफ वाटर एब्जॉर्प्शन, देयर आर टू थ्योरीज गिवन टू एक्सप्लेन द प्रोसेस ऑफ वाटर एब्जॉर्प्शन, एक्टिव एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर एंड पैसिव एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर. एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर बाई एक्सपेंडिचर ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक एनर्जी इज कॉल्ड एक्टिव एब्जॉर्प्शन एंड एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर विदाउट द एक्सपेंडिचर ऑफ एनर्जी इज कॉल्ड पैसिव एब्जॉर्प्शन. वाटर एब्जॉर्प्शन इन विच द रूट सेल्स प्ले एन एक्टिव रोल इन द एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर इज कॉल्ड एक्टिव एब्जॉर्प्शन. प्रोसेस इज कैरीड ऑन बाई कंजप्शन ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एटीपी. टू थ्योरी हैज बीन गिवन टू एक्सप्लेन द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्टिव एब्जॉर्प्शन, ऑस्मोटिक थ्योरी ऑफ एक्टिव एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑस्मोटिक थ्योरी ऑफ एक्टिव एब्जॉर्प्शन. दिस थ्योरी वॉज प्रपोज बाई ऑकिन एंड प्रीस्टले. ऑस्मोटिक थ्योरी ऑफ एक्टिव एब्जॉर्प्शन, दिस थ्योरी वॉज गिवेन बाई ऑकिन एंड प्रीस्टले. अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस थ्योरी वाटर इज एब्जॉर्ब फ्रॉम द सॉइल इन टू द जाइलम ऑफ रूट अकॉर्डिंग टू ऑस्मोटिक ग्रेडियंट, मीन द डिफरेंस इन द ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर इन साइड द सेल एंड आउटसाइड इन टू सॉइल. रूट हेयर्स कॉन्टेन ए लार्ज वैक्यूल विच इज फिल्ड विद सेल शेप. कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ सेल शेप इज हायर देन सॉइल वाटर. द ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर ऑफ सेल शेप ऑफ रूट हेयर्स इज हायर देन द ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर ऑफ सॉइल वाटर. देयरफॉर द डीपीडी और सक्शन प्रेशर इन द रूट हेयर बिकम हायर एंड वाटर फ्रॉम सॉइल एंटर्स इन टू द रूट हेयर थ्रू प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन बाई ऑस्मोटिक डिफ्यूजन. एज ए रिजल्ट द ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर, सक्शन प्रेशर एंड डिफ्यूजन प्रेशर डेफिसिट ऑफ रूट हेयर नाउ बिकम लोअर व्हाइल देयर टर्गर प्रेशर इज इंक्रीज्ड. टर्गर प्रेशर ऑफ रूट हेयर गेट इंक्रीज बट द सक्शन प्रेशर ऑफ और ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर ऑफ कॉर्टिकल सेल्स इज हायर इन कंपेरिजन टू द ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर ऑफ रूट हेयर्स. देयरफॉर वाटर फ्रॉम रूट हेयर्स गोज टू कॉर्टिकल सेल्स एंड सक्सेसफुली इनटू द जाइलम सेल. नाउ द कॉर्टिकल सेल्स एडजेसेंट टू रूट हेयर्स हैव हायर ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर, सक्शन प्रेशर एंड डिफ्यूजन प्रेशर डेफिसिट इन कंपेरिजन टू द रूट हेयर. देयरफॉर वाटर इज ड्रॉन इन टू कॉर्टिकल सेल्स फ्रॉम रूट हेयर्स बाई ऑस्मोटिक डिफ्यूजन. इन द सेम मैनर वाटर बाई सेल टू सेल ऑस्मोटिक डिफ्यूजन ग्रेजुअली रीचेज एंडोडर्मिस. ऑस्मोटिक डिफ्यूजन ऑफ वाटर इनटू एंडोडर्मिस टेक प्लेस थ्रू पैसेज सेल्स. वाटर फ्रॉम एंडोडर्मल सेल्स इज drawn into the cell of pericycle and from pericycles to the xylem basin. Xylem conduct this water root to stem, stem to leaves. Non-osmotic theory of active absorption. Non-osmotic theory of active absorption was proposed by Bennett, Clark and Thielman in 1951. According to this theory, water is absorbed against the osmotic gradient. Sometimes, when the osmotic pressure of soil water is higher than the osmotic pressure of root hair cells, in such condition also root hair absorb water from the soil. According to this theory, water is absorbed against the osmotic gradient. In some cases, it is observed that absorption of water takes place even when the osmotic pressure of soil water is higher than the osmotic pressure of cell say. So this type of absorption, which is non-osmotic and against the osmotic gradients, requires the expenditure of metabolic energy, probably through respirations. Following evidence support this view. The factor which increase the rate of respiration will also increase the rate of water absorption. Poison which retard metabolic activities of the root cells also retard water absorption. The rate of transpiration and water absorption is almost equal. Movement of water takes place against the gradient of osmotic pressure. For example, the shape in xylem basal has low osmotic pressure in comparison to cortical cells, root hairs and other root cells. In spite of that, water moves from root hair to xylem basals through cortex, endodermis and pericycles. Passive absorption of water. According to this theory, passive absorption of water takes place when rate of transpiration is usually high. Rapid evaporation of water from the leaf during transpiration creates a tension in water in the xylem of the leaves. This tension is transmitted to water in xylem of root through the xylem of stem. Due to this, water rises upward into the cortical cells through root hairs to reach the xylem of the root to maintain the supply of water. In according to this theory, root hairs are not responsible for the water absorption, but the mesodermal cells of leaves or epidermal cells of leaves are responsible for the absorption of water through roots. Through the stomata, water is continuously lost from the leaves, due to which the osmotic pressure of stomata or god cells of stomata increase, which absorb water from neighboring cells or accessory cells. They absorb water from mesophyll cells, mesophyll cells from the xylem basals of the leaves. From the xylem basals, this transpiration pull or tension force transmitted downwardly up to the xylem of roots, from xylem of roots to pericycle, endodermis, cortical cells, then finally to epidermal cells and through epidermal cells to the root hairs. Thus, due to these tensions, root hairs absorb water from the soil. So the force or the transpiration pool of this entry of water is created in leaves due to rapid transpiration, and hence the root cells remain passive during this process. Many workers like Carmer and Lesmier have put forth some evidences in support of passive absorption of water. Some of them are: rate of transpiration and water absorption is directly proportional. Movement of water always takes place in a direction against the gradient of osmotic potential. Water absorption is controlled by transpiration. Factors affecting water absorption. Both external and internal factors are responsible for the water absorption. External factors are temperature of soils. Temperature of soil, increase in soil temperature up to about 30 degree centigrade favors water absorption. At low temperature also water absorption decrease so much so that at about 0 degree it is almost checked. It is because at low temperature the viscosity of water and protoplasm is increased, permeability of cell membrane is decreased, rate of growth and elongation of roots are checked, metabolic activities of root cells are decreased. Concentration of soil solution osmotic pressure of a solution depend upon its concentration. If the soil solution is highly concentrated due to presence of salts etc., its osmotic pressure will be gradually increased, which will inhibit the absorption of water. Therefore, absorption of water is poor in alkaline soil and marshy places. Soil layer. Absorption of water is retarded in poorly aerated soil because in such soil deficiency of oxygen and consequently accumulation of carbon dioxide will retard the metabolic activities of roots. Roots also require oxygen for respiration to produce energy. Energy is required for absorption of water. This also inhibits rapid growth and elongation of root so that they are deprived of the fresh supply of water in the soil. Availability of soil water. Availability of water in the soil will also regulate the process of water absorption. Decrease in the soil water below the permanent melting percentage cause considerable decrease in the absorption of water. Increased amount of water beyond the field capacity affect the aeration of the soil, causing decrease in the absorption of water. Internal factors. Some internal factors which affect the water absorption are the transpiration or rate of transpiration. Transpiration is the loss of water from aerial part of plants in the form of water vapors. There exists a direct correlation between the rate of transpiration and absorption of water and minerals from soil. When the rate of transpiration is high, rate of water absorption is also high. In reverse condition, absorption of water is adversely affected. Extent of root system. Means root system is highly developed or poorly developed, affect the rate of absorption. A more developed root system absorbs water with a rapid rate. The process of water absorption is largely controlled by the density of root hairs and branching of the root systems. Moreover, the capacity of water absorption by older root is comparatively lower in comparison to that of new roots. Metabolic activity or metabolism is chemical reactions taking place inside the living cells. Rate of metabolism in root hair cells is directly retarded due to process of water absorption. High rate of metabolism favor rapid rate of water absorption. According to many scientists, water absorption is an energy dependent process. The difference between active and passive absorption. Active absorption requires metabolic energy. Passive absorption does not require metabolic energy. एक्टिविजेशन कैन नॉट टेक प्लेस इन द अब्सेंस ऑफ रूट्स, पैसिविजेशन कैन टेक प्लेस इवन इन द अब्सेंस ऑफ रूट्स, एक्टिविजेशन क्रिएट ए पॉजिटिव प्रेशर इन द जाइलम चैनल, पैसिविजेशन प्रोड्यूस ए नेगेटिव प्रेशर इन जाइलम चैनल, एक्टिविजेशन इज नॉट इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय ट्रांसपिरेशन, पैसिविजेशन डिपेंड अपॉन ट्रांसपिरेशन, इन एक्टिविजेशन रूट सेल्स प्ले एन एक्टिव रोल इन द एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर, इन पैसिविजेशन रूट सेल्स हैव नो रोल इन द एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर, एक्टिविजेशन क्रिएट ए पॉजिटिव प्रेशर इन द जाइलम चैनल, पैसिविजेशन क्रिएट ए नेगेटिव प्रेशर